Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be discussing decentralizing artificial intelligence data with the blockchain technology. So if you want to hear more about it, stay tuned. Don't you go anywhere. Welcome back. So yesterday I saw on the news that the UK government spent more than £500,000 for one tool to detect jihadist content and block it from being viewed online, with a hope to reduce radicalization, which will in turn reduce terror attacks. So what they've done is they paid an artificial intelligence company to train a model with data to be able to detect this type of content. So these models become more intelligent through repetitive learning. Let's just say it's like you trying to train your dog to learn how to shake hands and you keep doing it until it can finally shake hands. But then for this to work properly, you need three things. So you need expertise, you need technology, and you need people. The main thing here is the people, because the people are the ones that will provide the data, find and provide the data that will then be fed to these models. It's just like how we, the people, spend so much time on social media platforms without actually realizing that we're giving out data with every single click. Like something as little as you just liking a picture on Facebook, you've literally just given out data because you've registered your interest in that type of picture. So if there was a person or a company that wanted to market something relating to that type of picture, you would then be the target because you've already registered your interest. I'm not sure if you guys have tried to do a Facebook ad before, but when you try to do a Facebook ad, the fees you pay is literally paying Facebook for the data that they've got from loads of people for free. So what if there was a way that you could get paid for the data that you share? This is where Bottos come in. So Bottos is a decentralized data sharing protocol based on the blockchain technology. Using this platform, the AI service and product providers can obtain specific training data for their models in a more economic way. So the data on this platform would actually be cheaper than they would get it anywhere else. And also the data sharers, so we the people, can declare ownership of the data as a personal asset. And then we can capitalize this asset via the token reward system. And then we can also have better control of data privacy through Bottos protection mechanism on the blockchain. For example, going back to the jihadist content that we spoke about before, for the models to have been trained properly to be able to recognize jihadist content on the internet, they would have had to be fed with loads of different types of quality data, ranging from videos to audios, maybe even keywords. So the model becomes intelligent enough to identify content that look or sound similar to the ones it's been fed with. So how do they get the content to do this? This is where data sharers come in. So data sharers can either be me or can be you or just anyone else. So how it works is we look for the data and then we upload the data to the Bottos platform on the blockchain, and the company that have requested the data collects the data and use it to train their models. Generally in the AI world, data acquisition is really, really expensive because these models need quality data, not just garbage data that's been pulled off from somewhere. And today, only the big tech giants like Facebook and Google have the ability to acquire these large amounts of data to train their own models. I mean, startup companies can barely afford to do this because of the high cost. So Bottos have come up with a platform to accommodate the data requester, the data validator, and the data sharer. So here, the data requester can be like an AI company or a developer. So what they do is they put out the data requirements on the Bottos platform, and then a data sharer can pick up these requirements and start the data gathering, and then after that, put the data reports back on the blockchain and then get tokens as a reward for the work that they've done. So you're probably wondering, if they're going to reward data sharers with tokens, what's stopping anyone from just making up data just to get tokens? This is where the data validators come in. So there's data validators on the network that would verify that the data is valid and the data is accurate. And then there's also a rating system based on the verification results. So data sharers will have rankings based on the quality of their work, and this will in turn affect their future payouts. So basically, the more valuable data you share, the more you're rewarded and more likely to get more just too many mores in here, to get more jobs, more jobs coming your way. So the higher your credit score as a data validator or a data sharer, the more money the data requester will have to pay you because you're already seen as a trusted source of data. So who are the people behind this platform called Bottos? Here's one of the co-founders. She used to work with Neo, Ting Ting Wang. I like her name, Ting Ting. And she's also the founder of a robot exoskeleton research and development company. The CEO, Sing Song, he has 13 years experience in high-tech investment and digital transformation and corporate strategy. They've also hired a group of top experts from IBM, and they have a group of professors as well from top schools. And they also have programmers with more than 10 years experience on their team. So they have a big vision, and the vision is to build an Ethereum-like ecosystem for the AI field to promote data sharing in an economic and a more democratic way. So this platform is going to be bigger than just being the middleman between data requesters and data sharers. There's so many business use cases, and they've linked some of them in their white paper. I'll link their white paper for you guys down below. Oh, and by the way, the name Bottos was coined from robots operating system. So Bottos, Bottos, and then Bottos, which means robot lover in Italian language. So they're also in partnership with HPB. HPB is the high performance blockchain. And these guys are working on a hardware chip to scale transactions to millions per second. I have a video on that project as well. So if you haven't seen that video, you haven't heard of HPB, I think they're really good projects. By the way, none of these videos are sponsored. You can click on that link and there's more information about HPB there. And I'm guessing that the reason they partnered with these guys is to find a hardware sharing network for communication among the Internet of Things. It kind of sounds like IOTA in a way. They also have strong partnerships with Arm. So Arm is an accelerator program that focuses on smart hardware and just Internet of Things ecosystem in general. So like companies that are involved with virtual reality, with smart cars, with smart health, and just things like that. So if you're a startup company and you're looking for accelerators to go and pitch your business, you might want to check Arm out. So because Bottos was part of this accelerator in China, they had the chance to meet loads of different AI companies that could potentially be customers on the Bottos platform. So they have the PC-based application that can be downloaded from their GitHub, and they have the Mac version too. But I think you have to contact them if you want the Mac version. So the first version is out now, and on that one, you just have the basic data requester and data sharer, and you can get some tokens. And then the second one is going to be out in March. And then the third one is going to be out in May. And this is the one that's going to be a whole new blockchain entirely, like the Ethereum ecosystem we're talking about, where loads of AI developers can build stuff. So let's have a look at this coin and coin market cap. So the coin for Bottos is BTO, and it's currently ranked in the lower region and trading at less than a dollar. The market cap and circulating supply haven't been updated here, but I did contact them though to ask, and the market cap is around $51 million right now, and the circulating supply right now is at 360 million, and the total supply, as we can see here, is 1 billion. So these are the exchanges they're listed on. So you're probably wondering, when are they going to hit the bigger exchanges? Well, the CEO said that, their lawyers said that they're not legally allowed to ask the exchanges to list them. That if we, the community, want them to be listed on the bigger exchanges, we have to go to the exchanges by ourselves. You know, maybe we'll have to do a vote or something and then ask them to list them. And then Bottos can provide the support that we need to do that. So that's what they have to say about exchange listing. They're not legally allowed to. So the AI market is already big, but as the demand for AI data and models increase, then the value of Bottos tokens will definitely appreciate. Probably already knew that. I think that the AI market cap in general is going to skyrocket because the government, hospitals, schools, you know, different sectors, self-driving cars, smart this, smart that, can use AI, and the demand is getting higher than what we're talking about. So yeah, if you're a lover of artificial intelligence and you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe so you don't miss my future videos. And I will see you on my next video. And if you did enter the coin giveaway in my ICO scam videos, stay tuned because I'm going to be picking the winner now. But if you didn't enter, bye. I'll see you on my next video. Give away this Litecoin. I'm going to go to my YouTube and copy the link. Then go into the random comment selection website. 27 unique comment. Start raffle. I think we have a winner here. Copy the address. Hopefully this is a Litecoin address. So this is my Coinbase account. I'm using this for the purpose of this video. I don't use Coinbase at all. But Coinbase is really good though if you're a beginner. So we're gonna send the max amount of Litecoin is one Litecoin here, and that's the equivalent. So the max amount will be this, because there's a network charge of 0.04p. Sorry, but you're gonna have to charge your network fee. So write a message from DG Dells on YouTube. And then we're gonna send. Oh, two-step verification. I'm just gonna enter that. So it's three. Confirm. Congratulations, whoever owns this account, your money is on its way. So that's it guys, I will see you on my next video. Bye.